Hi, beauties. So today I wanted to film my drinking station or my coffee station. This is how I start my day every morning, and it's usually the my very favorite part of the day. So I just wanted to show you kind of how my routine is. I think this will be really helpful for people who are looking to get into a healthy routine if you are starting an active lifestyle, or people who are newly sober and are looking for ways to obviously change their lifestyle and start new habits. These are some ways that I have found very helpful in my new life of sobriety. So I drink a lot of coffee, and I'm just gonna show you kind of my whole routine. And I apologize, I do have a cold today, so I'm a little bit raspy. Anyways, here is my drink station in my little house or my apartment. So I always have a candle by my coffee pot, and I usually light it at the beginning of the day. And I keep it lit for the first few hours of my morning. It just kind of brings joy to my heart, and I really like just bringing a new scent and that kind of thing just to start the day right. And it kind of gives me like a calm feeling. And then here's my coffee pot, and I just use a traditional coffee pot. And I do that because I drink a lot of coffee. I don't drink, you know, any alcohol or anything anymore. And so this first year of my sobriety, I've just allowed myself to drink as much coffee as I need, I guess, or I feel I need to get through the day. I've done a couple cleanses this last year, but for the most part, I drink 2 or 5 to 5 cups of coffee a day, which I know seems like a lot, but honestly, the other option, which what I was used to do, was drinking, you know, 2 to 3 bottles of wine a night, or a day, depending on the day. And so I feel like this is the lesser of two evils. I always make sure to keep hydrated with filtered water during the day. So I'm not just drinking coffee, but I do allow myself to drink as much coffee as I feel I need. And then this is the rest of my drink station. I have this canister here is of my coffee, and it's just pre-ground because I don't have the best coffee grinder, so I just get it pre-ground when I purchase it. And I have a little, and it's airtight, and then I have a little spoon in here which helps me to measure it out. And I like to drink my coffee pretty strong, so I usually just kind of tip this over when I'm getting my coffee ready in here, and I just kind of dump in as much as I think is going to be good for the amount of coffee that I brewed, or the amount of water that I'm going to be using. And then next to this, I always have seasonal flavors. So right now I have cinnamon and pumpkin spice, and these are just natural spices, but I just keep them out here, and I'll either dash them into the coffee grounds before I brew it, or I'll put it straight into my cup. And then next to that, I have stevia in the raw, and this is a low glycemic, all natural sweetener. And so I use that to sweeten my coffee. And then I have next to the sink and at the end here, just another small spoon that I always keep on this spoon rest, and I just rinse it. Then I wash it, you know, once a week to get a good cleanse out of it. So that is my basic setup. And then above in the cupboard right above it, I have all of my mugs, and I just collect a bunch of different fun mugs. I have my seasonal ones mostly are in the front, but I have I think this is a fox, and I think this is a squirrel maybe. Anyways, I got them. I found them. They're really cute. I only get mugs that are on sale. That's my rule. So I collect mugs, but I only get them on sale, which makes it a little bit more fun to kind of hunt for them. And then I love my smiley face mug. That's not seasonal. That just stays out always. And then I have a little Christmas guy back here. Isn't he cute? He is almost as cute as my dog. So I love him. I haven't used him yet, but I'm gonna bust him out at a special time. And then above my glassware, I have, this is not very organized, but I just have a bunch of different teas. This one I should be drinking right now, and my sister made it. It's like an all herbal remedy tea, and it actually really helps if you have like a cold. I'll try to post the recipe below, but my sister just made that from a bunch of different herbs that she ordered from an organic company. And then I have like a one filter coffee in case I need to make like a friend coffee at night or something if they're over and I'm not going to make a whole pot. And then I just have a bunch of different teas, and I'm going to figure out how to organize these better, but I have like a
vanilla hazelnut. I have a throat coat tea. I have a smooth move tea. I have some dark chocolate, hot chocolate for guests. And I have some chai for guests. And I also have Good Earth sweet and spicy tea, which is the best tea for evenings. So I don't drink a lot of tea during the day, but I do drink it at night. So that's what I have up there. And that I need to get that more organized, like in a basket, but that's how it is for now. And then I'm gonna show you just how I prepare my coffee. So I always pick a mug that I, you know, feel inspired by that day. I feel like mugs are kind of like perfume. So it's like whatever mood you're in. So I am gonna use my C mug today. This is my all time favorite mug. And then I'm gonna show you a few ways that I flavor my tea, my coffee. Now, I follow, I have some personal trainers or online trainers, Karina and Katrina from Tone It Up, and they always say only drink your coffee with almond milk, which I totally agree with. That's a really good way to drink your coffee. However, again, in my first year of sobriety, I've decided that I'm going to treat myself to drink my coffee how I want, because I'm not drinking all those calories in wine. I mean, I don't ever, you know, I never have alcohol in, so, or a lot of other things, because I do have some food allergies. So I feel like my creamer is my little kind of treat through the day. So I rarely eat dessert or like chocolate or anything. I've tried to really cut back on that kind of stuff. So I feel like my cream is kind of my thing. So right now I have two of them that are in my fridge. I have the mint chocolate, and it's coconut milk. I don't actually drink real dairy. So this is coconut milk chocolate, mint chocolate. And it could be a little bit more minty and a little more chocolatey, but it's okay. So I drink this every once in a while when I'm really feeling like I need a little chocolate. It's almost better just in a glass on its own rather than in coffee, because I feel like it gets really diluted. However, I do keep that on hand because sometimes you just need some chocolate. And then this one is my favorite. There's different flavors. I've seen hazelnut and just plain, but the French vanilla is so good. So I generally put this in my coffee, and I just do it before I put the coffee in. I put it at the bottom of the mug. So I'll just show you how I do it. I'm just gonna shake this up, and I'm gonna stick this in. And I just put a little bit in, depending on how much coffee I'm gonna drink. It stands up pretty well in coffee, so you don't need a ton. And in case you're wondering, there's 20 calories in one tablespoon, and there is the total carbs are 4 grams of carbs and 4 grams of sugar. So it's pretty high in sugar and pretty high in carbs, obviously, because there's sugar. But yeah, there's cane syrup in it, but that's probably why I love it so much. But nonetheless, and then I'm feeling like a little cinnamon in my coffee as well. So I just dash this right in here because I didn't put it in my actual coffee grounds today. So just a little cinnamon. And then I just pour my coffee in, and then I don't have to stir it. I'm gonna have my stirrer in case I need to, although I might want to stir up the cinnamon a little more. Yeah, I want to stir the cinnamon a little more. So that's how I do that. And then there you go. There's your coffee for the day. And this is how I start my morning. From here, I take my dog out with my hot cup of coffee, and then I come back in and I do time with the Lord, and I do like a Bible study, and I write in my journal and kind of write my intentions for the day. And that's really helped me kind of stay focused through this last year. Getting sober and just staying focused on what my dreams and my goals are, my morals and that kind of thing. And that's really helped me when I kind of start to feel weak. And it also just starts my day really well. And then I usually go into a morning workout, and from there I start my day and start work. So yeah, I usually start my day about 5:30 in the morning, and this is how I begin. Thanks for listening, ladies. Talk to you soon. Bye.